Hello out there. Good evening, everyone. I hope this finds you well. It is 7 o'clock. Well, 6:59. Hello. Hi, Kevin. Tonight is, hi, Patty. Tonight is restore and release, self-myofascial release, self-massage, all that good stuff. Hi, Maritza. And we're taking it to 45 minutes. It's been 30 minutes in the past, but tonight is 45. And then we'll do a 15-minute guided meditation to finish off, get you nice and relaxed. Hi, Nazi. So in terms of what you'll need, lacrosse ball works great, tennis ball, even a racquetball, something like that. If you don't have a foam roller. Good evening, Neha. Thank you, Nazi. So Anna, you can have a mean foam roller or a nice smooth one, whatever you got in your house, right? So yeah, go ahead and gather those things. A mat, of course, and if you're sticking around for guided meditation, some blanket, pillow, anything to keep you nice and comfortable. For some reason, one of my lights went out, so 1 second. I'm stinky. Oh, lovely. There we go. Fixed. Hello, Shalika. Okay, so I didn't get any comments on what you guys needed in terms of body parts, so I'm gonna go with what I need, and hopefully it'll help you guys too. I'm going to, no worries, Shalika, have a great night. I'm gonna target the legs. Hopefully you guys, everywhere, I like that, Nazi. So I'm gonna start with the foam roller. If you don't have a foam roller, you can certainly use one or two lacrosse balls, tennis balls, whatever works. And of course, starting with the calves. Good evening, Lisa. So, just like today in class, I'm going to stack my legs right away and run the full length of my calf muscle. Just try and find, I got plenty of issues happening in there right now, but so dig in, look for it, find it. Oh my gosh, I'm already getting stink face. And please, in the comments, write if there's some area in particular that you have need of targeting, because we can definitely get that for you. We have 45 minutes, which is awesome. To work on the areas that are most needed, right? Once you find your spot, 10 times quick up and down, 10 times quick side to side. I'll get some nice music on, soothing, relaxing music. Hello, Denise. Neck, yes, definitely. We got in a little bit of neck last week and it was so good, right? Awesome. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna lean forward, putting a little more pressure on top of that spot. Breathe in and out. Try and relax as much as you can. The tendency is to tense up and to not, because it hurts. It doesn't feel amazing. But trying to really concentrate on relaxing the body is only going to benefit you in the long run. So Think like your butter melting over top of that foam roller or ball. Good. Three, two, one. Awesome. And then find another spot. Rolling back and forth. If it's too much to stack your legs, I would just have one on the floor or to the side, but really focusing on one leg only. Your body always defers to the better leg. It's like, yeah, no, I don't want to feel that, so I'm going to go with the side that feels better. Just like human nature, right? Good. Now, in case you have never done this before and you're wondering what this is all about, they're saying, actually, science is saying that static stretching, which is where you hold, go ahead and point and flex your foot while I'm talking. When you static stretch prior to exercise, it's not that static stretching is bad. Hi, Sandy. It's just that if you do it prior to exercise, it can inhibit your performance. Go ahead and tick-tock that foot side to side. But that if you foam roll, or if you do this self-myofascial release, it actually does not impede your performance, which is fantastic. So, stretching takes your muscle fibers and it pulls them further apart. And then when you have to try and perform, your muscles have to work all that more hard to come together to fire. So, but this right here is just working your fascia out. It's getting the knots and the crunchies in that layer that's on top of your muscles to release so that you can actually perform better. So, and it keeps your muscles healthy too. So, front side of exercise and back side of exercise, both, anytime basically, good. Okay, let's go to the other leg. Roll the full length if you can, find a spot. Typically mid joint is where you're gonna find your most issues. Hi Paris, hi Sheen. Once you find a spot, oh yeah, little tiny movements up and down and side to side, 10 and 10. Hi, Amy. Hi, Priya. Good to have you guys. Good. Oof. And we're gonna do that same point and flex. So go ahead and point and flex that foot. Breathe. Very easy to hold your breath with this one. Good. Oh my gosh. Right? And then tick-tock that foot back and forth. Just like this, like a windshield wiper. Some circles in both directions. Nice. And then roll all the way through and find another spot. Good. Now last week I said we were going to get the adductors and we didn't end up getting them, so it's my plan to do it tonight. In case you didn't know what the adductors were, they're the inside of the quad, or the thigh. Inside of the thigh, we're gonna target that tonight. It's one of those, I did not know that that hurt right there. Good. 10 times up and down, 10 times side to side. And then when you're ready, point and flex the foot. I don't know if I'm ever ready for this part. Ow. Hi, then windshield wipe back and forth. Oh my gosh. Are you guys feeling this? So again, I probably sound like a broken record, but I like to repeat the why behind what we're doing because it keeps you coming back to this. Doesn't, you don't have to necessarily come back to me. That's not what matters. And circles. What matters is that you take care of yourself, right? And you want to be doing this for the long haul. You want to be exercising the rest of your life. It keeps you healthy and strong and happy. And so go the other direction. Foam rolling, self-myofascial release, any style is absolutely essential. It's going to keep your body, and I firmly believe that I would probably not have taught, I would have not taught today had I not taken care of myself this weekend. I took time, I really worked and rolled my leg, I soaked in Epsom salt baths. If you don't take care of yourself, you get hurt and you stay hurt, and then you get sad because you can't exercise, right? Go ahead and lean into that leg, relax. Think really calming, soothing thoughts. Breathe in and exhale out. Awesome. Good. So when you do this, you actually get better flexibility, mobility, longevity with your exercise, and better metabolism. Yes. Okay, this is a new one for some of you. We're gonna get the shins. Now, if you're a runner, this is awesome sauce right here. We're gonna focus on one leg at a time. You can use a ball, certainly, or you can use that foam roller. I'm just gonna demonstrate with the foam roller. You're gonna be on all fours, and then one shin is going to be on the actual foam roller. Now, if you have the ball, you can really target this strip right here. If you're on the foam roller, and it's a mean one especially, you'll want to kind of lean toward this strip instead of being right on the bone, because the bone just hurts. That makes sense. So, slight lean, and then you're just rolling all the way up and down. You want to be on the mediest part of your shin, not on the bone, because the bone just hurts. Unless you have a smooth, kind foam roller, unlike I do. Hi, Jennifer. Hi, Isabel. So, really leaning in. Oh my gosh. This is another one where you're just like, I don't know. Why? Why didn't I know that this hurt until I actually went off? What the heck? Good. Oh. Feel like I can't find a spot. It's just my entire shin is the spot. I don't know if you guys feel that way. Good. I'm just gonna focus in on the where I think I need it the most. And you can set your toes down, flexed foot, and just push back and forth. If you have the ball underneath you, you're going to be obviously much lower to the ground. If you have a yoga block that you can use to kind of prop and give you a little bit of a lift, use it. If not, a book, a couple books might work to do the trick, or you can just be on the floor. Floor works too. Hi, Liz. Gosh, okay. I'm gonna relax my foot. So I'm gonna take the top of my foot, toes back, and lay it down, and allow my body to come right over top of that leg. Ow, ow, ow. And breathe. Good. And then I'm going to rock a little bit. Forward and back, and side to side. And roll through. Oh my goodness. Goodness gracious. Are you okay? All right. We're gonna get the other side. Same thing. Now remember, you have to take that angle with this one, right? You wanna be rolling this strip and not the actual shin bone. It just hurts. So, rule of thumb for foam rolling is to not roll bone. Anything close to the skin that's bone, it just doesn't feel right. Okay. Get in there, find it, dig. Oh, yeah. Tight, tight, tight. Hi, Milan. Good to have you. We're working the shins right now. Slight angle, foam roller or ball, either one works. Good. Once you find a spot, plant your toes, flex your foot, and dig in. Up and down, side to side. And in case you didn't know, all of these particular movement patterns, they help your, on a cellular level, to activate relaxation. So that's why we do it. Hi, Elaine. Jolene. Oh, shoot, Elaine, I'm so sorry. Well, I'm glad you made it. I hope, obviously, that your power's back on, maybe. Good. All right, we're gonna get into it, into that nitty-gritty. Come on down. Take your foot back, pointed position. Let the top of your foot rest back behind you. And let your whole body come on top of that leg. Oh, yeah. Good. And when you're ready, shift forward and back. And side to side. Things I do appreciate about foam rolling is that while the pain is momentary, the results are, they last a little bit longer and you're happier for it. It actually releases endorphins, so why wouldn't you do it, right? Okay, let's target, we'll go back to the backside. Let's target the hamstrings, okay? I'm gonna continue to use my foam roller, but I'm gonna show you how to use a ball. If that's the tool that you have. We've done this before. Okay, taking the ball right back behind base of the glute where the hamstring insertion point is, where your hammies meet your bum. All right, you're gonna have a seat right on top of that ball and you're gonna lean to that side. Same thing if you have the foam roller, only one leg at a time. Right in that lip, right where the meeting is. And then you're keeping that same leg that you're working straight out in front of you and you're just going to point and flex. Oh yeah. Good. You guys okay? Nice. And then a little tick tock side to side. demonstrate later for the neck. This will have to do. Apologies. Oh, the joys of having kids at home 24/7, right? Good. Let's go ahead and lean in to that leg. Bring your whole body weight forward over top. Big breath in and exhale out. Try and relax as much as you can that leg that is outstretched. Hi, Vivian. Good to have you. Keep breathing. I know it's harder when you are hunched over your diaphragm. Continue to take as deep breath as you can. And exhale out, relaxing just a little bit more. Three, two, and one. Good, go ahead and roll up. Oh, so good. Okay, we're gonna get the other side. Awesome. Mama Jo, it's good to have you. I miss your face. Good. Okay, rolling. Same position, opposite side. I miss a lot of people's faces. I'm sure we all do, right? It's coming. It's coming. We're getting there. Good. Pointing and flexing that foot back and forth. This is my bad side. It's talking to me. Mm-hmm. Saying all kinds of mean things to me. Expletives that I can't say on camera. Good. And side to side. So oftentimes, where we're experiencing pain is actually not the source of the pain. It's a referred or triggered, you know, that area is triggered by other areas. So for me, my knee pain was actually tightness, extreme tightness in my calves, IT band, my hips, for a variety of reasons, lots and lots and lots of movement, exercise, all right? And then do another bend and straighten on this side, bend the knee, straighten, like you're pressing down into the ball or the foam roller. And so once I figured out, you know, oh yes, this is why my knee is feeling so crappy. I do have knee issues, but it's not the knee itself. It's the surrounding areas that cause pull, because if something is too tight, it pulls extra. It's like extra stress on the joint. And that's why targeting all these areas is super beneficial. Well, hello, Bella. Thanks for coming. Good. And we're going to melt. It's almost like an oxymoron, right? Go ahead and bring your whole body forward. Get as deep a breath as you can. And think melty thoughts, relaxing thoughts. Good. Nice. If you know anybody who experiences some pain, make sure you pass this on. If it's going to help them in any way, shape, or form, hey, that's what this is all about, right? Good. Three, two, and one. Nice. Now, for this next one, my preference is the foam roller. So if you're using a ball, you certainly can continue to use it if you don't have a foam roller. But if you do have both tools, try and grab the foam roller. It covers a little more ground. And then that's kind of what you need for this next part. All right, I'll show you what I mean. by using the ball. Now if you have two, again, a little bit better because you're trying to cover so much ground. But essentially you're gonna take and move the ball up and down the adductors, which are the inner thigh muscles, okay? If you have the foam roller, you're taking and you're Xing it across your leg, all right? You're gonna be facing down, low plank position, other leg nice and comfortable on the floor, but you're here. It's one of the more awkward foam rolling techniques, but once you're on, you're gonna be like, oh yeah, that's why we're doing it. Good. Oh, I think I see the bag of tricks. I'm gonna go grab them in a second. My kids did not hide them. Good. And again, I'll demonstrate with the balls. So a lot lower to the ground, but you can still achieve similar results. Y'all still out there? You still with me? That's okay, Bella. You know what? It doesn't matter. As long as you get it in, right? As long as you take care of yourself. I found it. Good. So if you have two, fantastic. You can roll the entire length up and down. Oh my gosh, what the hey? Right? Good, find a spot. My particular area that I feel it the most is like from the top of the knee up. That's where it's like, oh my gosh. Seriously, your other leg can be fully extended. Get as comfortable as you can and just use the top leg that's on top to push and pull. Good. And then once you've found a spot, a little press in, like you're trying to press that leg into the ball or foam roller. Pressing down. Good. Now if you can handle it, we're going to add some movement again to that. So you're going to press down and then you're going to extend the leg and then you're going to bend it back. Oh, I got a laughing, smiley face. This must feel really good. In a very facetious way, right? Bend and straighten that leg. Keep that press down. Good. Oh my gosh. Good. Okay. Now we're trying to melt. It's kind of crazy. Feels like you can't, but yes, you can. Think melty thoughts. If you need to lay down, sometimes that helps too. Try and relax. Don't tense up your glutes. Good. Three, two, and one. Great job, you guys. Let's switch sides. Stephanie! Yay! One of my faithfuls when we have had classes at the gym would rarely miss a foam rolling class. Okay, exit across that leg, get into that position. I know, awkward, but so good, right? Yeah, this is my bad side. I feel like I say that a lot. Again, most of my issues are from midway all the way to the top of the knee. That's where I'm feeling it the most. So you know where you need to go. Oh man. to stop and breathe a little, do it, right? Whatever you need to do to get through this, knowing that the pain, the momentary pain, is worth the outcome. Absolutely. Right, Nazi? Yes, ouch, but it's good. It's like a hurt so good. Knowing that it's going to actually help you, and it really does. That's what keeps you going, plus the feel-good moment after. Okay, we're gonna press down. Press down and fully extend and bend that leg. Oh my goodness gracious. Whew. Awesome. Back and forth. We're going to melt, so bring your body as low as you can and try and relax as much as you can. Benefits, right? Okay. We're gonna head to the back side. Now, if you have only one ball, that's okay. Try and split the time. We're going to be rolling up the spinal column, starting in the lumbar spine region. If you have the foam roller, that's fine. You can use that as well. My preference is these or tennis balls, some kind of ball that can fit in that groove right next to your spinal column. Super beneficial, helps release a whole lot of tightness. And then we'll end with the neck. It's the one and only request for tonight, which is good. We need those requests, right? Because I want you guys to get what you need out of this. Okay, so nice and low on the back side. Nice and low. We're looking at like right here, right where, like right above, tailbone, or not the tailbone, I shouldn't say that, is right above the sacrum, okay? You're gonna lay right on top, and again, if you have a foam roller, you can utilize that. So nice and low, laying back behind. Try and relax into it. Let your hips drop to the floor. Up and down, hips side to side. Just get in there, work it a little. You can do that with the foam roller as well. Up and down, side to side. Most everybody has at least tennis balls in their house or some kind of ball. But I promise you, this will be one of the best investments you ever make. It's like $4 a ball. Why not? You can't beat it. There are some balls that you can get that are specific to this, and they have a little more give than a lacrosse ball where you can actually squish them. I'd highly recommend those. You can get them on Amazon. They're called yoga tune-up balls. Awesome. I think for the set you can get them for like $12-$13, which a little more pricey, but they come with a mesh bag and they're awesome. We have them at the club too. Okay, so now if you want, there's several options I'm gonna walk you through. You can stay right where you're at. This one feels amazing in my opinion. Or you can utilize some furniture.
have it right near your feet and place your feet on top of the furniture. So if you need to pause me and go grab some furniture to do that, great. If you don't want to pause me, place your hands on the floor and you feel up to this. Take a tabletop your legs, but your hands have to support you, okay? Tabletop legs, and when you're ready, you can corkscrew side to side. You can do this with the foam roller as well.
Tissue that's like it's tighter together, right? Start to head into a little bit more lat attachments, so it gets a little tighter the further up you go. So if you're in case you're feeling that when you're going side to side, good, get a lot of up and down.
We're not going to tabletop the legs anymore, so feel free to move up when you are ready. Another inch up. Now we are like just under the bra line, ladies. Gentlemen, it would be kind of right underneath where your heart rate monitor would sit. Definitely harder to go side to side, so I would just stick to that nice up and down along the channels of your spinal column. Good. Try not to hold your breath, it's easy to do. Good. All right. Now at this point, you should be right at that midsection of the back, ladies' bra line, definitely on the bra line at this point. And if you need more, you can lift your hips up. If your hips get tired or your quads get tired holding yourself, place some pillows underneath you for support. That should be helpful, and up and down again. Good.
Awesome, let's move another inch up. So now above, we're heading into the actual upper back at this point. So right about there. If you also have a foam roller, you can put it underneath your hips as well. It's a nice tool to help kind of support you so that you're not putting so much pressure on the quads. Oh yeah, that's good. Awesome. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're gonna do a little bit of work before we head into the neck region. Okay. I want you to shimmy those shoulders. Yes. Take your arms out in a T. Good. And move up and down again with the arms extended. And I want you to do some reconnaissance. Find an area in this upper back region. Just one. We don't have time to go over more, but find one spot as you're rolling up and down that really sings to you. Once you find that spot, stay there, and we're going to take a T and close the hands together and open back up. Good. And T, open back up. Good. Awesome. If you have a pillow or a hand towel that you can roll up, and we're going to place the two balls back behind the neck, okay, and then on top of the pillow or hand towel that's about, it should be at least that thick, yeah, and we're going to get into a nice relaxed position. We're going to sail right into our guided meditation from this particular move. Comfortable through this process. So whatever you need to do, I'll give you a few moments to get ready. And in case you are wondering what this guided meditation is like, it's simply a journey. There's no weird chanting or anything like that. I just keep it really simple. Lots of good breathing that's going to help you feel relaxed and give you a better sleep tonight. Of techniques to help calm your mind and make you feel completely at peace, okay? So that's what the rest of this time is going to be about. So go ahead and get into position. And what we're gonna do is with the balls there, I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to try and continue to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Thank you, Nazi. Okay, and first we're going to take the back of the head and you're going to press down like you're trying to push the balls into the floor. Now, if you don't have these, you can certainly use that foam roller. It's a good tool as well, and it kind of fits right back behind the neck. It's not as effective as the lacrosse balls, but Still works. Hey, Sarah. All right, so keep doing that. Press back behind and release. This is really so good. There's a lot of this happening in our world. I do it too. Sitting over a computer, thank you, Neha. You know, over your phone, bad posture. It's a habit that's hard to break. So this is helping to reset that cervical spine. Very, very good tool right here. Good. Now, take your head and neck side to side, ear to shoulder, back and forth. Still back behind, laying relaxed. You can do whatever you want with your limbs. Keep rotating side to side. Excellent. And now you're going to take and lift your chin, tucking the foam roller or balls almost back behind you. Lift and release. Now, if you're just joining or watching, you should be laying down on the floor and not holding the balls here. Good. Keep lifting, tucking, and releasing. Finally, last one, tuck the chin to the chest and then release, tuck and release. If you can add breath to any of these movements, do it. Good. Exhaling. Good. Balls, the foam roller, or you can just keep it there. It's completely up to you. We're going to head into our guided meditation now. And for those of you that have neck issues, that have chronic maybe headaches or feel like you can never feel right in the neck, one amazing piece of advice that I was given to by a chiropractor is to take a hand towel and fold it and then roll it up so it is about the space between your neck and wherever you're laying on the bed, basically. Taking that towel and laying on it for 5 to 10 minutes every night is gonna help reset, because your cervical spine, your neck should have a nice C curve to it. And with all of the forward fold that we have going on, it goes away. So do that every night, and I'm gonna guarantee that you're gonna feel better in no time. So rolled up towel back behind the neck, just laying down flat, no other pillow, just flat on your bed, and you'll see results and feel results. Good. Okay, nice and relaxed. I want you guys to let your limbs go. Starting with your fingers and toes, I want you to feel like they're almost melting into the floor. Feel the weight that is starting in your fingertips and toes. Like someone's massaging you and pressing into you on the table. It's that kind of sensation. Imagine that you're feeling it pressing into your limbs, a weight, it's almost like a heavy blanket laying on top of you as well, pressing down, starting to move into your knees to the thighs, the quads, and the biceps of the arms. Continuing up to the shoulders and the hips. Heavy but peaceful. Journey takes us to a place where you feel weightless, but it's heavy at the same time. You are swimming in the ocean, but you're deep. You've got your scuba gear on, so you can breathe for long and extended periods of time, and you're at a coral reef that is just remarkable. The colors on display and the marine life is very prolific and beautiful, and you can see fish of every kind. Here you just feel weightless. No worries, no cares, just taking in the beauty that is under the water. Hearing yourself breathe. Watching the bubbles float by as you breathe through your mask. Surrounded by beauty. You can see the sun piercing the water, shining through seaweed and reflecting and bouncing off the coral. Fish darting everywhere. And like I said, you feel weightless in the best way possible. Slowly, you start to make your way to the surface as it's time. And the tank that you were using is pretty much used up. Broken the surface of the water, you feel lighter, you feel weightless, and more relaxed. You hop up onto the boat, peel back your wetsuit, and sit with your flippers hanging off the edge, and just think for a moment what you just saw. Content, light, happy. Thank you guys so much for coming this evening, for sticking around for this last little bit. I appreciate you, and I leave you with a wonderful thought of the evening. A smile is happiness you'll find right under your nose. Right? It's right there. You just have to bring it out. It takes more energy to frown than it does to smile, and you just might make someone's day. Thank you guys so much. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your evening. And we will see you tomorrow for LIIT, 8 a.m. Love you all.